Hi, everybody. Welcome to the demo, the show where companies come in and they show us their latest products and services. Today, I am joined by Swati Malhotra. She is the Senior Engagement Manager at EXL. Welcome to the show, Swati.
Thanks, Keith.
All right. So what are you showing us today here on the show?
So Keith, we know AI adoption, it's becoming increasingly strategic across industries. So today I'm going to talk about Code Harbor. It is a multi-agent solution, which primarily accelerates platform migration and workflow assessment. Meanwhile, it also facilitates data discovery, data governance. It streamlines code conversion, code optimization, and also brings efficiency in end-to-end testing.
Okay, and generally, who is this designed for within an enterprise? I'm assuming IT coders, developers, those kinds?
Yeah, and not just limited to that. Okay. The solution is really geared towards business leaders as well. So, you know, as I mentioned, we work with our clients on their cloud transformation journey. Now, typically, these projects are very long. They are resource intensive, right? They demand huge investments, both for time as well as budget. You need people, you need developers who are experts on multiple programming languages. What we've also seen a lot of times, there is insufficient documentation, you know, of these legacy codes and applications. Mm-hmm. So the way we have really designed Code Harbor is to cater to these different stages of migration by bringing together these multiple AI agents in a dynamic orchestration layer. So that would help you right from, you know, code assessment, code prioritization, you know, metadata creation, tracking lineages, tracking transformations, doing the actual code conversion, generating test cases, you know, debugging the code, and finally, you know, tuning the code for performance optimization.
Right.
So it's geared towards business leaders, towards CIOs, CTOs, CDOs who are looking to modernize their tech infrastructure, who are looking to refresh their data pipelines, optimizing their codes, who are looking to streamline this pre and post migration testing landscape.
Yep.
So if I have to summarize, organizations who are migrating from legacy systems to more crowd-friendly modern platforms, data professionals who are working on ETL pipelines, you know, data transformations, QA teams who are responsible for testing, for performance analysis, and primarily CIOs and IT decision makers who are driving these digital initiatives.
And when you hear the term code migration, I'm probably sure that everyone gets a big headache and they just, you know, they're thinking like, oh, this is a multi-year project. This is going to take forever. If they didn't have something like Code Harbor, they would be probably going through a lot of these long projects, correct?
Yeah. So
or even manual, right?
So I was actually speaking to one of my clients the other day. He said, you know, by the time this migration is done, I would be retiring.
Oh, wow.
So yes, if enterprises, they don't have a solution like Code Harbor, they're looking at two scenarios. One, they would be going with a completely manual, human-driven approach, which, as you said, would take a very long time.
Yeah.
Or either they would be relying on these individual developer AI toolkits, which are more generic in nature and primarily geared towards enhancing day-to-day developer efficiency rather than being really tuned for specific migration use cases like Code Harbor is.
All right, so you've got a lot of cool features here to the show. Let's jump right into the demo.
Sure. So for the demo today, what we'll do is we're going to transform a sample ETL SAS code to Python.
Okay.
But it's not just a code conversion. I will also be highlighting the different assessment and governance agents. You know, we'll showcase the code conversion and optimization. We'll generate the synthetic test data, and then we'll test the code and perform data validation.
Okay.
So it's going to be catering to, like I said, you know, different stages of migration. So this is a sample ETL SAS code, which I uploaded to the solution. Let's go through the modules. So code analysis. Code analysis really is an under the hood analysis of the source code, in this case, the SAS code. And it primarily, you know, highlights the composition of the code, you know, what are the key dependencies of the code? Are there any external libraries that are being referenced? Are there any files or data that's being imported? So overall, it helps us to really understand the complexity of the code. And it gives an idea to the developer, you know, what's the effort involved in migrating this code.
Okay.
Code explanation, you know, it's a very detailed summary of the code. It breaks down the code and actually creates a pseudocode or, you know, English descriptions of the code. And this really helps when, you know, we have developers who are proficient in one language but not the other.
Right.
So this really creates a documentation of the code. It saves hours and hours of pre-work, and especially helpful, you know, like I said, when the original authors of the code, they are no longer around in the organization and there's just a new team which inherits these codes. So this documentation is very, very powerful for them. Data dictionary. So we know data governance is a very critical aspect of a migration initiative. So using the dictionary agent, we can actually create the end-to-end metadata, right? It extracts the key tables, the key variables, you know, creates a description for those variables as well, and very importantly, tracks transformation logics. So now, this is actually plain English, which anybody can read, right? From the business teams to the IT teams. It really breaks down the transformation logic into simple English. And it does this at every step of the code for every variable, for every table. Once we generate the data lineage, once we generate the metadata, what we do is we leverage that metadata to track the lineage, right? So this lineage really helps us to establish the interdependencies across these different data assets and variables. It tells us, you know, the parent tables or the parent variables, the source tables, source columns, and just helps us to establish or track changes across enterprise data. Yeah. Now, this lineage that you're seeing today, it's just across one code. However, this can be tracked across multiple codes belonging to the same language or across codes of different programming languages as well. So once we assess the code and we extract the metadata, the next step for us is to actually convert the code. But before we even go into conversion, we're going to break down the code into logical segments. Okay. And that's what the chunking agent will do. And this is very important because it pretty much refactors the code. It simplifies the source code for conversion. And that results in a more optimal conversion of the code.
Right. Rather than doing it in one pass,
exactly.
You've cut it into...
Exactly.
And it just makes it more efficient that way?
Yes. Yeah. Yes. It makes it much more efficient that way. It's much easier for the LLMs to also process and convert the code instead of just passing it in one go. And these LLMs, as we know, you know, most of these come with a context window limitation.
Yeah.
So it's not ideal to pass the full code in one go. So once we chunk the code, we actually leverage that chunked code to convert. And in this case, we are converting this SAS code to Python. So this is where each chunk gets converted to a target language of choice.
Okay.
Once the code conversion is complete, the next step for us is to leverage synthetic data. Now, very interestingly, Code Harbor, just taking code as an input, we were able to create a documentation from the code. We were able to create the metadata to convert the code. And we leverage that metadata to generate test cases through our synthetic data module, right? Mm-hmm. So the solution is not really dependent on any external data or any reference data to create test cases. And that's where we, again, really harness the power of these large language models. So we leverage the metadata that gets generated in the data dictionary agent for all the input tables, and we create the synthetic data for these.
Is using the synthetic data for testing purposes?
Yes.
Is it just because a lot of companies don't want to actually go with the live data yet until they're sure that the code is working?
Yes, that's a scenario.
Yeah.
But a lot of times, you know, our clients, you know, they're open to sharing codes with us in our environment. You know, they would not be open to sharing their data.
Okay.
So that's where we, you know, whenever we are converting any codes in EXL environment, we leverage our synthetic data module to perform in-house testing before we ship the code in our client's environment where the production data testing happens.
Yeah, that's another great reason. Thank you. All right, so you've got the synthetic data.
Right.
What's the next step?
So the next step is to test the converted code on this synthetic data. And our iterative debug module will actually assist the developers in solving for errors that we'll encounter in the code. So far, as you can see, every section of the code is getting executed on the synthetic data. So far, there's not been any error. But as soon as we see any potential error, the assisted debugger is going to kick in, like in this case, and over a certain number of attempts, it's going to resolve for the errors in the code. So again, it's saving hours and hours of work for these developers. And, you know, testing is a significant effort. I would say 50% of migration effort is just on testing. And that's where our, you know, our iterative debug module really saves, a lot of time. So let's go to the data validation. So once the code is debugged and refactored, our final step is to compare the output that gets generated from the source code, which in this case, again, is SAS, and from the target code, which would be Python, over a series of data validation metrics like conformity, duplicity, format checks, also checking whether the output is matching, whether the column names are matching or not. So this really ensures that we are not just converting the code, we are not just debugging the code, we are also making sure that there is output conformity as well, right? So as you can see here, comparing two different tables from both SAS, comparing the same table across SAS and Python, we are checking the output value across various metrics.
All right, and I just wrote down some quick stats from you guys, and this allows 3 to 4x speed for digital and cloud transformation, 60% faster process for documentation, and a 20% reduction in code compute time. That's really impressive.
Yes. Yeah. And the demo that I showed today, this was on SAS to Python. However, there are many language combinations that we can leverage Code Harbor for, native or traditional SQL to more cloud SQL, Java servlet to microservices, R to Python, SAS to PySpark. So there are many combinations that we are seeing with our clients that we can leverage Code Harbor for. Another thing, there are different ways in which our clients can consume Code Harbor. We have integrated all of these different agents as an IDE plugin, like VS Code. So a lot of our clients are actually leveraging these agents as different modules of the VS Code plugin.
All right, so what's the best way for a client to reach out to you guys and see a demo or get more information, because there's a ton here and it looks awesome.
So this solution, it's not really an off-the-shelf capability, right? We really fine-tune and customize these for every client, like to cater to those specific client needs. The orchestration layer in itself needs to be fine-tuned for every client. So we do, offer demos. We do invest in free POCs as well with our clients, to really show the value of this solution. And, you can always reach us at codeharbor@exlservice.com.
All right, Swati, again, thanks again for showing us the demo.
Pleasure.
That's all the time we have for today's episode. Be sure to like the video, subscribe to the channel, and add any thoughts you have below. Join us every week for new episodes of Demo. I'm Keith Shaw. Thanks for watching.